I confess that sometimes I don't believe that God is all sufficient, that God supplies every one of my needs. Yeah, it's true. And how can I say that and be earnest about that and prove that? Because I'm asking God to supply what I think I need. I ask Him to supply what I think that I am lacking. You know, MacGyver, he never prayed, "Oh God, please give me this piece of material and that piece of material, and please God, I need this in order to make this thing work." No. MacGyver knows that whatever he needs, it's right there in front of him. He's just got to look, he's just got to be creative, he's just got to utilize, right? So MacGyver is never in need. He always finds what he needs. And sometimes we, spiritually speaking, look at other places and look at other things and look at other people, and we think, wow, they've got it made. They've got abundance. They've got more than enough. Man, look at all the stuff that they have that I don't. Well, if I don't have it, then that must mean I lack. And that must mean I'm in need. But you know what? That's not always necessarily so. I mean, there's something to be said about the scripture that says that, you know, God will give to those who are responsible and prove worthy and do the most with what little they have. And God will give the increase. God will give them more to be responsible for if they prove they can be responsible with a little task, a small task, with a little responsibility. God really convicted me one time when I was praying for my congregation. I'm like, "Oh, Lord God, we need this position filled, and we need that position filled, and we need these kind of people, and we need this to happen, we need that to happen, and in order for this to be done, we need this, and in order for that to be done, we need that. Oh, God, please help us, we need this, and give us this, and give us that. Oh, Lord, we're in a catch-22 situation. How can we get this if we don't have that in the first place? Oh, woe is me, wah. And God finally said, "Enough." And I went to this conference, and this guy was talking about small congregations. And he used the example of Gideon. He says, limited resources doesn't necessarily mean limited impact. Limited resources doesn't mean limited impact. And he was making the point that you got to use what you have. You've got to understand what you have, because you're actually sitting on a gold mine. You're actually sitting on so much untapped potential. You actually have everything that you need, and you need to first utilize that to the best of your ability, show that you are responsible and a good steward and doing your best with what you have. And then God will give the increase. God will give you what you imagine or what you think you lack, and He'll give you more to be responsible for. And he used the illustration of Gideon. Gideon at first had hundreds, thousands of men ready, willing, and able to be his army. And God said, no, that's too many people. You need to shave it down. What? So God tells Gideon to run these men through a series of tests. And by a process of elimination, he ends up with only 300 people. 300 people. And they're supposed to defeat an entire army. God, how are we going to defeat an entire army with just 300 people? Well, if you had more than 300 and you had those thousands and thousands, you can brag and say that you did it. But because you have so little, that it can only be a miracle, that it can only be by my grace and my efforts upon you that you conquered this entire army with just 300 men. And oh, it's like God punched me in the gut. I mean, he just pricked my heart. And I'm like, "Oh God, I'm so sorry for praying for this to happen and that for that to happen, and praying that you would send this person along and that person along, and you would fill this position, you would fill that position." I said, "God, I get it. I'm sorry. I confess. I need to work with what I have. I need to tap in and exhaust the resources that I have and watch you bless and watch you increase with what I think is old, tired, worn out, not enough. Because you are the God of Gideon, therefore you are the God of my situation. And Lord, you can grow this people, you can grow this church, and you can grow this congregation." And so now I don't pray that these positions be filled. because I know God's going to fill them. But first, I need to work with what I have and be thankful for what I have, tap into the potential and utilize what I have to the very best of my ability. I've got to first show God that I'm responsible for the little before he will give me more to be responsible for, and before God will bless and increase. So we're not to look at what we lack. We're not to look at what we don't have. We're to look at what we already have and see how we can use what we have to its fullest degree and potential, maybe in a way that we never thought before. I mean, there's something to be said about that hymn. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. My dad would always say, you know what? I used to feel sorry for myself because, I was poor and my old shabby shoes. But then I looked at a man who had no feet. And it made me thankful for the shoes that I did have. And I realized I wasn't in desperate need as I thought I was for a pair of new shoes. Hey guys, that's the Raw Confessional for today. Thanks so much for listening. Go out there and have a great day. God bless. AbrahamsDescendants.com. Getting back to the first century in a 21st century way. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to press the like button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and the notification bell that'll let you know every time I make a new video. And don't forget to share this with a friend. Also, visit our website at AbrahamsDescendants.com. Thanks. Shalom. Thanks for watching. Stay connected by subscribing to our other social media accounts and visiting our website at AbrahamsDescendants.com.